outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping. Lights are turned down low. Let it snow, when we finally kiss goodnight. Now I'll hate going out in the storm, but if you really hold me tight.
Morning, Kay.
The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbye. As long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Morning, Monica.
The weather outside is frightful, but that fire is delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought lots of corn.
Morning, folks.
The lights are way down low, so let it snow, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally say goodnight,
morning, everyone.
I'll hate going out in the storm, but if you
morning.
Hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying. Goodbye.
Just to give everyone a couple of minutes.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Morning, everyone. A bit too much, some of you might be saying this morning, but there you go. I wanted to bring something bright in this morning for everybody. So we'll just give everyone a couple of minutes and then we'll begin. Hope everybody's okay. It's a bit fresh down here, bit of snow on the ground. I'm not sure what it's like where you are, but it's a bit fresh here. Morning, Linda, how you doing? All right, Nikki, how's everybody doing? Morning. Going to put some music on in the background. Let's just get this up. So after that nice Christmas carol with the snow, I just thought it was quite apt this morning, to be honest with you. I'm going to change this a little bit now. How's everybody doing? So we're going to begin. So we give thanks that we're gathered here today, and we ask that this place be filled with love, light and friendship and healing energies, and surround us in protection as we open our hearts and expand our consciousness to allow the flow of love and healing to come through to each of us. As your crown chakra opens and you feel or imagine a column of pure white light filling your whole being, and then feel the balance of harmony within your body as the earth energies rise up through the soles of your feet to your base chakra, and you feel the connection to the universal source of pure unconditional love, balanced by the nurturing, protective love of Mother Earth. So Harry Edwards prayer. May I be thankful for the blessings I already have, and grant me relief from pain and sickness, and protect me from all ills, and grant me good health in the days to come. Remove all causes of imperfection and bring your healing ministers close to me, that I might be conscious of their presence and so receive guidance and inspiration. And grant me courage and fortitude to overcome all adversity, and let me be conscious of your strength in times of need. And grant me confidence to overcome my fears and not to anticipate harm. Teach me how to live rightly in your sight, to do only that which is right and true. And I pray that good guidance and right influence will inspire all your people to be as brothers one to the other, and that peace shall endure for all time. So, we ask that all people whose names we hold in the distant healing folder may receive healing for their highest good. We also request that their family and friends and people for whom they've requested distant healing. And so for just one moment, be still and know that healing is being sent. So perhaps all of us in our own way, just for one moment, just send out healing to our family, our friends and people we've heard of for just one moment. Thank you very much, folks. So the Healing Sanctuary Prayer. Heavenly Father, may I surrender myself to the good influences of your healing ministers in spirit, that through your divine healing powers, the disharmonies within me may be overcome, and the stresses of mind and body be eased and lessened day by day. Help me to adopt a more positive and helpful way of thought, and bringing me closer in harmony with those around me and with the divine healing purpose, and for those who are sick or in darkness of despair who do not know of the help that can reach them from spirit, I pray that the awareness will come to them soon, that they too may experience the upliftment of spirit that can lead us through all harmony to true health. So folks, I hope everybody's okay, and you've got a nice day lined up, maybe sledging, something like that, because I know there's quite a bit of snow around, it's quite fresh, so wherever you are, maybe go and have a brisk walk somewhere, but hopefully we can have a nice day, each of us in our own way. I want to read you something that Harry Edwards said, and then perhaps build on that thread a little bit today. So I'm going to read you something that Harry said, and then I'm going to perhaps talk us through a little meditation on the same theme, and then read a poem. So let's begin. Harry said, "Nature has it right. Just listen. Look up at the sky. See those clouds that don't need to know where they're going. They're just going, drifting, with the air currents only to disappear into the atmosphere. It's a continuous cycle of life that actually began beneath the earth's surface as rainwater. You're part of that cycle of life. The need to know should be dropped occasionally and replaced with being. There's an intelligence within nature. It lies within every seed and every creature. You can't see it with the naked eye, and you won't acknowledge its existence very often. And this intelligence is the blueprint from which all creation was born. Can you acknowledge it? And can you link with it? And yes, you can. Basically, Harry was saying some of the ways that we can link with the energies around us, because that's where he channeled energies from spirits, but within nature, these healing energies that we can all tap into as well. So on that kind of note, what I wanted to do today was just build on a little meditation with that in mind, perhaps, about just being and maybe changing our reaction to things that happen to us. So maybe if you want to get yourselves nice and comfortable wherever you are, just maybe close your eyes and we'll begin that. So folks, just settling in. So this meditation is perhaps just to inspire you, to give you food for thought. So just close your eyes if you wish to. Maybe just beginning to settle in. Just begin to relax. And as you close your eyes, try to feel the greatness inside of you. Because it's there. Sometimes we lose touch with that. We become drawn into the external world. So just sitting comfortably. And the doorway into that is through the breath. So focus on your breathing perhaps. Breathing calmly and slowly. Nice and relaxed. And exhaling all the way out. Let it all go. Becoming aware of you being here in this moment, you and I, and all this great family of Harry Edwards and the community. Imagine all of us just being together. And perhaps that sense of comfort that brings, for each of us are not alone. And you know the truth is, everything begins with a thought. Everything is mindset. And you do not become what you hope for or what you desire. You become what you truly convinced you are from deep within your soul, your spirit. And with your eyes closed, perhaps you could now visualize the highest, most purest and complete version of yourself. Imagine that creation, seeing that convincing thought of that image of yourself. See if you can see that clearly every day. The most highest and purest and complete version of yourself. And Harry said, you are the light of the world. What would happen if you conjured up that image of yourself as pure awareness and pure light? What changes? You don't become what you hope for or what you desire. You become what you're truly convinced you are. You are light of this world. From deep within, everything begins with a thought. And be aware of when your thoughts are out of alignment with your highest self. And don't allow yourself to get lost in the negative thought patterns. Just that awareness of your true nature. Each of us connected to each other beyond spoken word, beyond the physicality. And if you've done something that goes against your purest, highest feeling, decide today. That was the last time. And that you won't go do that again. And when you start a life of greater awareness, when you can really get in touch with your higher self, you'll discover you've been living most of your life on automatic pilot. And you're not aware of the thoughts that are creating your reality. You're not aware that your actions will determine your behavior. You are not aware of you, your true nature. You were not aware of you. Be mindful of every thought and every word and every action which is not in alignment with who you truly are and who you want to be. Take distance. Step back. Create space here, now. And feel rest within that space that you've created. As if you're resting your head on the softest, purest pillar. And let that space create hope within you. Comfort. Let it soothe your soul, your spirit. And with that awareness, I wonder if you could live from a place of self-forgiveness, self-love, from compassion and kindness towards yourself. And when you're in touch with a pure being, and connected with your higher self, you become more and more aware of the choices you make from a different mindset. Feel that love, that space, ever expansive. You are light of the world. Connected to those beautiful healing energies around you. And bathe in your own magnificence. Be in awe of your own wondrous journey. Such love. Such peace fills your whole being. And this whole process is a shift towards higher consciousness as you're reconnecting and making that connection to your higher self, that awareness, connecting with the divine presence and those healing energies Harry so often talks about. And with this awareness, I ask you a question. Who are you? And what do you want to be? What dreams, what visions, what thoughts do you want to turn into your own reality? Believe in yourself. Believe in your tremendous inner strength and power. And be aware of the magical power of your positive thoughts. And understand everything you can imagine here, you can achieve. Everything you can imagine, you can create. To have faith in yourself is the greatest power. And if you go for it today, do anything and everything to make it happen. Give it all you've got. And never give up. Never quit. If you go for it, give it all you've got. Do whatever's necessary. And live from that place of faith and trust. Live from that space of pure awareness of your true nature. Your light of the world. And from that point of light within the mind of God, light has come forth into the minds of men. And light is now anchored on earth. And from the point of love within the heart of God, love has come forth into the hearts of men. And love has returned to earth. And from the center where the will of God is known, and purpose is guiding the little worlds of men, and the purpose which the masters know and serve, and from the center which we call the race of men, the plan of love and light is working out and cleansing harmful energies. Love, light and power are restoring the plan on earth. So want to read you a little poem from Helen Steiner Rice. And you can keep your eyes closed if you wish to. It's called Look at the Sunny Side. There are always two sides, the good and the bad, and the dark and the light, and the sad and the glad. But in looking back over the good and the bad, we're aware of the number of good things we've had, and in counting our blessings, which we find were through, we've no reason at all to complain or to be blue. So thank God for all the good things He has already done, and be grateful to Him for the battles you've won. And know that the same God who helped you before is ready and willing to help you once more. And then with faith in your heart, reach out for God's hand and accept what He sends that you can't understand. For our Father in heaven always knows what's best, and if you trust His wisdom, your life will be blessed. So always remember, whatever betide you, you're never alone, for God is beside you. So perhaps wherever you are, stretching your fingers and stretching your toes, put your hands on your heart and tell yourself, I love you. I'm gonna look after you. There you go, folks. Listen, I hope everybody has a great day today, wherever you're doing. And remember, you can always ring Harry Edwards Healing Sanctuary and have your names added to the prayer book. And just to let you know, someone's always there at the end of the phone. And these meditations are most days of the week, one way or another. And you've got a really good community and great, great people there that you can tap into. So I'm going to love you and leave you, and have a great day, folks. And look after yourselves and look after each other. God bless. See you later, folks. Thank you.